Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. In previous modules, you have studied about water, air, energy sources and waste management status in India. In this module, we shall be learning about current status of biodiversity in India. In paper number 3, you will study that what is biodiversity, what are different types of biodiversity, what are the you can say advantages of biodiversity, etcetera, etcetera. If you are interested to know more about biodiversity in detail, then I will suggest you to please go for paper number 3 in this environmental science subject. So, the objectives of this module are that what is the status of biodiversity in India, then we will discuss what are the biodiversity hotspots in India, then we will have a look on the animal, plant and fish biodiversity of India. Then we will have some discussion on agricultural crops and domesticated animal biodiversity in India. Along with that, we will also learn about Indian forest cover and biodiversity conservation initiatives in India. Then we will have a look on wetlands, then some of the conservation strategies that have been started by the government of India for the protection of wildlife will also be discussed, and this include Project Tiger, Project Elephant, Project Rhino, Ganga Dolphin Project, Crocodile, etcetera. And in addition to that, we will also discuss the new initiatives taken by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. You know, India is one of the biodiversity country out of 17 identified mega diverse countries. India has only 2.4% of the world's land area, but it accumulates about 7 to 8% species of flora and fauna. This includes more than 45,000 species of plants and more than 91,000 species of animals. Being one of the largest diverse nation, India has 10 biogeographic zones and have 11.8% species of plants, 8.58% species of mammals, 13.66% species of birds, 7.91% species of reptiles, 4.66% species of amphibians, and 11.72% species of fishes of the total world population. So, based on this data, we can say that India is a home to a number of plants as well as animal species of all kinds. Out of 34 globally identified biodiversity hotspots, 4 biodiversity hotspots are present in India, and these are Himalayas, then Indo-Burmas, the Western Ghat, Sri Lanka and Sundaland. These 4 belongs to India. So, let we have a look on them one by one. Himalayas. Western and Eastern Himalayas form part of Himalayan global biodiversity hotspots. As far as the Western Ghats are concerned, the parts of Western Ghat, Sri Lanka global biodiversity hotspot, they will come under this Western Ghats. Then in the Northern East, part of Indo-Burma global biodiversity hotspot, that will come under this. Then Nicobar Islands, that is the 4th biodiversity hotspot. The parts of the Sundaland that comes under Nicobar Island, that is also a part of global biodiversity hotspot. Let we have a look on the animal biodiversity of India. This figure shows the animal biodiversity of India. With only about 2.4% of the world's total land surface, India has over 6.7% of the total animal species that world holds. This figure is the representation of evaluated Indian fauna, about 4,681 species under IUCN threat categories, and this figure has been taken from India's 5th national report to the conservation of biological diversity, that is published by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Government of India. This shows that the animal biodiversity in India is at least some of the species are under critically, some are under endangered category, some are near threatened, and a good number of species is in the vulnerable and lower risk category. So this data shows that immediate attention should be given to the biodiversity, animal biodiversity conservation. Now, let we have a look on the Indian threatened fauna. This figure has also been taken from India's fifth national report to the Conservation on Biological Diversity, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. This shows that about 70 species of the birds are threatened. Similarly, about 50 reptile species are threatened, about 70 amphibian species are threatened, and more than 200 species of fishes are threatened, and about 90 species of mammals are threatened in India. So from this figure, we can infer that a number of species are threatened in India. This table shows the plant diversity in India with an estimated 29,105 species of algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperms, and angiosperms. India holds 9.13% of the world's known floral diversity in these groups. So, if you see, this table shows that about 7,000 species out of 40,000 species of algae are present in India, and this constitute to be about 17%. Similarly, 2,500 species of bryophytes are present in India, and about 1,200 species of pteridophytes are present in India. About 18,000 species of angiosperm, that constitute about 7.17% of the total world species of angiosperm, are present in India. In totality, we can say about 9.13% of the total plant biodiversity of this earth is present in India. This figure shows the floral, this plant biodiversity under threat. From this figure, we find that some of the species are already extinct, some are critically endangered, some are endangered, some are vulnerable. So again, as we discussed about animal diversity, here also immediate attention is required for the conservation of plant biodiversity. Marine biodiversity is also very important. The marine floral and faunal biodiversity of India is remarkable, with over 200 diatom species, 90 dinoflagellates, 844 marine algae, 560 species of corals, and 39 mangrove species, more than 10,000 invertebrate species, and 2,500 vertebrate species are marine in India. India's coastal and marine area holds many biological treasures. Dense mangrove forests of Sundarbans, the world's largest congregations of nesting turtles is in Odisha, beautiful seagrass beds in Park Bay, dolphins and dugongs in the Gulf of Mannar, majestic whale sharks in the Gulf of Kutch, and some of the world's most beautiful coral reefs are found in India. We have a look on the endemism species in India. In terms of endemism of vertebrate groups, India's global ranking is 10th in birds with 69 species, 5th in reptiles with 156 species, 7th in amphibians with 110 species. Endemism is manifested most prominently in the Indian fauna among the amphibia, that is about 16.2%, and reptilia, that is 47%. It is estimated that 62% of the known amphibian species are endemic to India, of which a majority are found in the Western Ghats. In plant endemism, India accommodates 47 families, 141 genera, and about 4,045 species of flowering plants, that is angiosperms. These are distributed in the floristically rich areas of northern East India, the Western Ghats, the Northwest Himalayas, and the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Geological Survey of India has recorded 3,022 species, which constitute about 9.41% of the known fish species of the world. National Bureau of Fish Genetic Resources has built up a database of about 2,553 native fish species of India, and it has generated information on the population genetic structure of 23 prioritized endemic and commercially important species. Agricultural crops and domesticated animal biodiversity also has a vast and rich repository of the animals and plants. This is represented by a broad spectrum of native breeds of cattle, that is about 34, then native breeds of buffalo about 12, goats 21, sheep 39, and chicken 15. India is also considered to be a center of origin of rice. To conserve India's rich domesticated biodiversity and promote crops and animal breeds, the Ministry of Agriculture has set up, and these six national bureaus are plant genetic resources, then animal genetic resources, then fish genetic resources, agriculturally important insects, then agriculturally important microorganism and soil sciences. Let me have a look on the Indian forest cover. As per India State of Forest Report 2015-16, India's forest and tree cover has been increased by 5,081 square kilometer. The total forest and tree cover in country is 79.42 million hectare. That accounts for 24.16% of the total geographical area of the country. The total forest cover of the country has increased by 3,775 square kilometer. Open forest area, that is increased by 4,744 square kilometer, and this accounts for 9.14% of the total geographical area of the nation. Very dense forest area is increased by 2,404 square kilometer and accounts for 2.61% of the total geographical area of the nation. Total carbon stock of the nation is increased by 1.48%, that is 103 million tons, and is estimated to be 7,044 million tons in the country's forests. State-wise, maximum increase in forest cover is reported from Tamil Nadu, that is 2,500 square kilometer. From Kerala, the increase in forest cover is reported by 1,317 square kilometer, and in Jammu and Kashmir, the increase in forest area is reported by 450 square kilometer. Largest forest cover in terms of area is in Madhya Pradesh, then it is followed by Arunachal Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. Highest percentage of forest cover is in Mizoram. About 88.93% of area of Mizoram state is under forest, and then it is followed by Lakshadweep. In Lakshadweep, 84.56% area is under forest cover. Mangroves, corals and sea grasses. India has a long coastline of about 7,517 kilometer in length, consisting of 2,383 kilometer of extensive coral reef beds and 4,667 kilometer of mangrove habitats that are home to more than 12,000 species of flora and fauna. Let me have a look on the biodiversity conservation in India. This includes protective areas, national parks, sanctuaries, conservation and community reserves. this table shows that in 2018, there were 103 national parks in India, and the total area under national parks is 40,500 square kilometer. And there are 544 wildlife sanctuaries in India, and the total area under wildlife sanctuaries is 118,931 square kilometer. There are 46 community reserves in India, and the total area under community reserves is 72.61 square kilometer. There are 76 conservation reserves, and total area under conservation reserves is 2,567 square kilometer, and there are 769 protected areas, and total area under protected areas is more than 1,62,000 square kilometer. Dear students, please do one assignment here. Take the map of India and try to find out the national parks, sanctuaries, community reserves, conservation reserves or protected areas in your state or in your vicinity, as well as also try to find out that what kind of biodiversity is present in that particular area and what method has been adopted for its conservation. This figure shows the number of national parks in different states of India, and from this figure you will find that there are 9 national parks in Madhya Pradesh, also 9 national parks in Andaman and Nicobar. Then you will find that there are 6 national parks in Kerala and Maharashtra each. In Uttarakhand also there are 6 national parks, and in West Bengal also there are 6 national parks. In some of the states like Bihar, Goa, Jharkhand, Manipur, Nagaland, Sikkim, Uttar Pradesh, there is only 1 national parks. So, dear students, please do one assignment here. Mark the location of these national parks on the map of India, and also try to find out what kind of biodiversity, floral as well as faunal, is present in these national parks. Let me have a look on the wetlands in India. India is bestocked with a rich diversity of wetlands, ranging from high altitude lakes of Himalayas, floodplains and marshes of the Gangetic Brahmaputra alluvial plains, saline flats of green Indian desert, to extensive mangrove marshes bordering the country's east and west coastline. As per remote sensing imagery based assessment, India has a total of 26 Ramsar wetland sites covering a total area of 12,119 square kilometer. Dear students, please make a list of different wetlands of India that are covered under Ramsar Convention. If you want to know more in detail about Ramsar Convention, I will suggest you please visit this environmental laws and policy paper. There is a detailed lecture on the wetlands conservation as well as on the Ramsar wetlands. Government of India has started a number of floral and faunal biodiversity conservation projects, so we will be discussing a few of them. Let me take the most prestigious project that is started by Government of India, that is Project Tiger. This project was launched by the Government of India in the year 1973 to save the endangered species of tiger in the country. Starting from 9 reserves in 1973 to 2016, the number is grown up to 50. The total area, about 71,000 square kilometer, is covered under Project Tiger. And it is evident now that because of this Project Tiger, the number of tigers in India has increased. Dear students, please find out that how much number of the tigers in India has increased since 1973 to today. The second prestigious project is the Project Elephant, as the name is indicated. This project was started for the protection of elephant. At present, there are 28 elephant reserves in India, and these are covering an area of about 61,830 square kilometer. And these have been notified formally by different state governments. Consent for establishment of two more elephant reserves, that is Khasi Elephant Reserve in Meghalaya and Dandeli Elephant Reserve in Karnataka, has been accorded by the Ministry of the Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Project Rhino, this is India Rhino Vision 2020. IRV 2020 is a partnership between the Assam Forest Department, the Bodoland Territorial Council, WWF, IRF, and the US Fish and Wildlife Service. The goal of this project is to have a wild population of at least 3,000 greater one-horned rhinos in the Indian state of Assam, spread over 7 protected areas by the year 2020. This IRV 2020 is an ambitious rhino range and population expansion program. Another project is the Indian Crocodile Conservation Project. The objective of Project Crocodile are to protect the remaining population of crocodiles in their natural habitat by creating sanctuaries and to rebuild natural population quickly through grow and release or rear and release techniques. Means the another objective is of this crocodile project is to promote the captive breeding of crocodile. Then Ganga Dolphin Conservation Program is for the conservation of Ganga Dolphin. The Ministry of Environment and Forest notified the Ganga River Dolphin as the national aquatic animal. This river dolphin or this Ganga Dolphin inhabit the Ganges, Brahmaputra, Meghna area and Karnafuli, Sangu River system of Nepal, India and Bangladesh. It is estimated that their total population is around 2000 and they are listed in Schedule 1 of the Wildlife Protection Act 1972. So, these are some of the major projects. In addition to this, a number of other projects have also been started for the conservation of biodiversity. So, dear students, please visit the site of Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change and try to find out that what are the another initiatives taken by Government of India for the protection of biodiversity. Other initiatives for environmental conservation, several other initiatives have been taken and these include conservation of natural resources and ecosystem, environment information, environmental education, environmental awareness, environmental management in heritage, pilgrimage and tourist centers including Taj Protection Social Forestry with communities. This is a Panchayat 1 Yojana project. So, number of projects are there. So, I will again suggest you to please visit the site of Ministry of Environment, Forest and Conservation to have the knowledge of different projects. So, to summarize this module, in this module, we have learnt about the animal biodiversity of India, plant biodiversity of India, and we have learnt about the marine biodiversity of India. Then we have had some idea of the wetlands in India, and then we have a look upon different projects started for the conservation of biodiversity by Government of India. Thank you.